guys and girls, welcome back to another episode of Spin Tires! Yes, I know you guys have been busting for me to do another video on Spin Tires, but guys and girls, to be honest with you, I've been trying to give Thunder Duck and the DCMT a chance to improve on their F450 heavy-duty truck. Now, the thing is this model, to me, looks like it's molded out of mashed potatoes. The bonnet lines are really rounded, and it looks like some of the things, like some of the details on it, were probably hand-drawn. And the other thing I really don't like about it is that it's been given this texture if it's been sitting out in the weather for a really, really long time, when an F450 of this design is kind of a current truck. So you kind of don't get this look unless it's been involved in, say, Hurricane Katrina. But anyway, guys and girls, that's enough about the model itself. The thing is this truck, apart from the way it looks, is actually really, really, really cool. You get so many add-ons, it's not funny. You can choose to have a utility bed, which basically gives you like 1,800 repair points and 800 liters of extra fuel. You can choose to have a dump bed with one of the coolest add-ons I think I've ever seen, which is the dump bed cover. Check this out. Look at that! Unreal! Love it! That's taken a lot of time to code, so that feature I definitely do like. Okay, also has a gate lock to stop things flying out the bed, which I think is awesome. You can choose to have the stock exhaust, which basically puts it underneath the vehicle, or you can choose to have it as stacks, which look really cool. You can choose to have it as a cistern, so you can carry around 5,500 litres of fuel, so you can drive this vehicle to go and refuel vehicles that have run out of fuel. You've got a stake bed, which I find pretty cool for... I'll just get rid of the dump bed so you can see the stake bed a bit better. Really good for loading up logs. You will have to manually load them yourself, but for me recently, I haven't been able to auto-load logs. It must have been a mod I downloaded, and it's ruined pretty much every loading point for every log place I've ever gotten, except for the log kiosk, so I have to manually load logs now. Boring. It has light bars on the top, which give it that flashy pattern. Pretty cool. You've got toolboxes you can add in underneath. You also have a box bed. I've just got to figure out what the combination is to get the box bed on. Let's see. If I do that... There we go. Got the box bed. It's got some weird graphic work on it. Kind of weird. It's like a removalist van type thing. Okay. But you can open up rear doors, load in a quad bike up the back if you can find a steep enough embankment to put it in. So yeah, a bit of a graphic glitch going on there. But then again, this is a work in progress, guys and girls. You also have the option of a furniture delivery as long as you put the stake bed. You can then basically... Oop, I messed it up. My bad. I can't remember what you need for the furniture delivery, but anyway, you'll find it out yourselves when you download the mod. But my favourite out of all is the rollback. Check it out, it's a rollback bed. This means that you could load up your favourite rock crawler. Excuse me. Load up your favourite rock crawler, take it to the rock crawling course, unload it, and you've saved yourself some fuel. Brilliant idea. Anyway, I'm going to show you how it works. You need to basically make sure that you've got the advanced menu switched on. You need to use the R and T keys. So I'm just going to slide the bed back as far as it goes. And then I'm going to tilt the bed as far as it goes. And some of you keen-eyed people would have noticed there was a Jeep sitting behind us. Okay, we're going to change into the Jeep. And what we're going to do is we're going to line the Jeep up with the back of the truck. Okay, whoop, nearly. There we go. And if you have difficulties, just use the winch points located on the tilt bed. Now, when this tilt bed is straight down, that winch point is actually up in the air, but you'll understand why it's up in the air, because it matches up with the winch point once the bed has been loaded on. So just winch yourself up a little bit further. Oop. Make sure you change it to pull and not accelerate. Right, we're on. All we got to do now is change back into the forward, hit the advanced menu, and we're going to tilt the bed flat. Slide the bed forward. Oop, run into a bit of difficulty there. So I will tilt the bed again. Oh, I haven't got enough grunt. Oh dear, the Jeep is a little heavy. Here we go. Up we go. I just got to get it in the right order. Right, and see how the suspension has sagged quite dramatically because I put the Jeep on? That's what this awesome invention called the load level is for. You can actually raise the suspension up so you get your ground clearance again. Look at that. Awesome sauce. Now, just to make sure that Jeep doesn't go anywhere, I am going to secure it with a winch rope. And off we go. So there you go, guys and girls. That is what the rollback is for. Take your favorite truck to its track, or bring one home. Now, this truck is not designed to be a trail truck. It is designed to basically use it to haul your favorite rock crawler or four-wheel drive to its favorite location. And then take it there. The reason why it's not very good as a trail truck is because the wheelbase is exceptionally long. It can be a bit of a handful when you've got a really, really heavy truck on board. But I was warned by Thunderduck that the WJ and the ZJ Jeeps really do weigh this truck down. But look at it, it's doing a fantastic job. So as I said, even though this truck is not designed to be a trail truck or anything like that, you could use it to go and successfully rescue a vehicle that has broken down. Now, to getting the trucks back off again is the opposite of putting it on. So we go back to tilt the bed. Slide the bed. Tilt the bed a bit more. That's the reason why you put the winch rope on. Okay. Change trucks. And just back her on down. And there you go, guys and girls. That's how you use the rollback on the Thunderduck F450. The DCMT F450, I should say. But there you go, guys and girls. You've just seen it haul a truck that is way too heavy for the tray. But I was warned about it. But there you go, it's done a fantastic job. Until next time, guys and girls, I will say bye for now. You can download the F450 from the Thunderduck garage page. Until then, I'll say bye for now.